God's doctrine of grace, that Yeshua has done everything, he has obeyed all the commandments, and the law is nailed to the cross, the commandments, so we are free. Absolutely not true. Law was not nailed to the cross. As Peter said, many have stumbled, and misinterpretation of Paul's writings, they have fallen headlong. These days, the Word of God is being taught, at least by some people, the truth for them to examine and see whether God has said these things or not. This is very important. Obedience to the commandments of God Almighty. There are about 613 commandments in the Old Covenant, and there are more than 100 commandments of Yeshua directly spoke, starting from the first commandments, repent. That's a command. So let's go over to Revelation chapter 14, verse 12. Revelations, I'm going to read from NASB, New American Standard, Revelation 14, verse 12. Here is the perseverance of saints who keep the commandments of God, or obey, and their faith in Yahushua. Perseverance of saints who obey the commandments or keep of Elohim and their faith in Yahushua. Where the Christian churches have gone far away from the basic about obedience. The devil has no problem with those who do not obey. But he's going to attack only those people who obey. It's very simple. So anybody wanting to know the truth and obey God, we need to give ear to what the scriptures say. The book of Philippians chapter 2 verse 5. Have this attitude in yourself, which was also in Messiah Yeshua, who, although he existed in the form of God, did not regard equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself, taking the form of a servant. Servant, and being made in the likeness of men, being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a stake. He obeyed was asked by the disciples whether he ate food when they had gone to buy food from the nearby shops, Yeshua said these words, John chapter 4 verse 34. Yeshua said to them, my food is to do the will of him who sent me and to accomplish his work. That was his food. And we all know food was given to all the creatures, starting from man. Elohim, God Almighty, gave food for the animals, for the birds, for all the creeping things, everything. Food was given. It was a plan of God. The food goes through the mouth, reacheth the stomach, and they get strong, strengthened, and they begin to grow. See what Yeshua said, my food is to do the will of him who sent me and to accomplish his work. Doing the will is obeying his commandments, whatever that he has said. That's doing the will. And to finish the work which he has given me. When we obey the commandments, the statutes, the truth, the principles, the instructions, ordinances, precepts, when we obey these things, it becomes our food. Becomes the nourishment. Obeying is eating the will of Elohim. Eating the word of Elohim. Simple as that. Our many, unfortunately, the good hearers of the food that is given in many churches, so-called, and the food is actually is not given to them. The real meat of God's word is our food to be eaten, and that happens when we obey the word. Becomes our food, and that food is for the new life, the life that is in Messiah Yeshua. Let's go over to Matthew 7. Is speaking over here. Not everyone who says to me, Master, Master, will enter the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father who is in heaven will enter. Many will say to me on that day, Master, Master, They be not prophesy in your name, and in your name cast out demons, and in your name perform many miracles. And then I will declare to them, I never knew you. Depart from me, you who practice lawlessness. Lawlessness is to throw away the commandments of Elohim and live according to our will. Professing Christians, that is all. He is rebuking these people for they were not subject to the law of Elohim. Continuing to speak about obedience. Verse 24, therefore everyone who hears these words of mine and acts on them, acts, obeys them, keeps them, the words, the instructions, may be compared to a wise man who built his house on the rock. Came and the winds blew and slammed against that house, and yet it did not fall, for it had been founded on the rock. The house is the life of that man. Building the house on the rock, the obedient life. He lived an obedient life. Trouble came, testing came. He was not shaken. His words are spoken by Yeshua. On the rock as a Christian, when he lives daily in obedience to the laws of God. We obey not to get salvation, we obey as an expression of love of what we have received through Elohim, the forgiveness in the name of Yahushua, because of what he had done on the cross, the stake. And continuing, verse 26, Matthew 7, everyone who hears these words of mine and does not act on them will be like a foolish man who built his house on the sand. And when you observe, there are not a few people who are foolish. These present times, they are believed in a building, I mean the Christians or the denominations or the name of the church or the pastor, and they begin to boast about all those things. But when it comes to obedience, no. Every few people will act on the word that they have received. But the foolish people grace of Elohim, and thinking deceptively that the laws have been done away with, they are going to really have a headlong fall. They will be like the foolish man who built his house on the sand, Yeshua said. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and slammed against. Slammed against the house, and the house fell. Great was the fall. These are the people who are going to be disappointed when Yeshua returns, but they could not stand for the testing, for they did not obey the commandments, the statutes, the truth, the instructions, even those ones brought by Yeshua, the Messiah, the Son of Elohim. Check up. Hold on to what is true.